Beam brush is a new hardware feature of your laser projector. And as this is a new hardware feature and a whole new parameter of control on your shows, you've added several new tools and effects to allow you to control and design with this new tool. The first additions we have made are in the Advanced Frame Editor. Below the color selection, you'll see the Beam Brush Value slider. Use this to select the value you want to work with. New lines drawn will use this value. If you want to adjust the value of lines already created, then you can hold Alt on your keyboard and use any of the coloring tools to rebrush the lines, like so. All blanked lines will go to the brush size of the next visible point. Now let's look at new effects we've added that pertain to Beam Brush. First, we have two new oscillating effects. The first is Beam Brush Oscillator. This effect has parameters like it's a wave effect. This will wave the brush between minimum and a maximum value set over the frame in the number of waves. You can also control the speed and give it a shift. Just like with wave effects, you can also change the wave itself from sinus to many others and even make your own waveform. We believe this will be a especially useful tool for those creating abstract content. The second oscillating type of beam brush is like most oscillating effects where you have a minimum and maximum and it moves all points of the frame between them at the speed you set. You can also change how this movement is done here, just like any other oscillating effect, and even make a custom waveform. This effect will be good for creating on-beat hits and movements for the brush in your live cues. One of the largest and most useful new additions for beam brush effects is the beam brush color type effect. Beam brush color effects work like any other color, brightness, or power effect, where you can set the values you want over this percentage area and it'll affect the points in the frame over that percentage area. You can also change how this percentage affects the area of the frame by points, axis, radius, time, or angle, and decide if you want to fade between the keys in the percentage area or be discrete changes. The other parameters you have are repeating the percentage area, its speed, and time shift. If you want to be transparent over the effects above it, and even set specific areas you want to apply it to. You can set any accelerations you want with the movement, and finally, you can change the centering of the effect for things like radius. You can change where the center applies. Now let's look at key effects. We have added a number of key effects for Beam Brush, many of which are similar to other effects in Beyond that are built for other parameters, and all work the same way, but changing the parameter value. So let's build a key effect using the first Beam Brush key effect, the brush value. In all key effects, we have this area where we can create keys and we can put values, and the time will move along this area to go to the values. You can also create different accelerations between them. This acts like a little timeline. You can change how much time the keyed area is using this period slider here, and whether it's beats or time. For brush value, our parameter is the total brush value of the frame. This overrides any previous brush values. For brush offset, this will shift the brush value positively or negatively from what it was before, so you can change the overall brush value of a frame while maintaining the aspect ratio of any previous brush values of the frame or queue. For brush limiter, this allows you to create a minimum maximum brush value that previous effects cannot go beyond. Brush inside lets you create a square brush mask. You determine the size of the mask and let the brush amount inside that mask. Brush outside is the opposite and lets you create a square brush mask. You determine the size of the mask and then the brush amount outside the mask. The last key effect is the brush ramp. This lets you set a start point and a finish point in a frame and then set a brush value from the beginning and end, which will then fade between the points and values. Thanks for watching our quick hints video on using beam brush effects and creation tools in Beyond. If you still have questions or need help, email support@pangolin.com and we can assist as soon as possible. And be sure to watch all our other quick hints videos on the beam brush additions to Beyond.